Today, I am super, super excited to share with you guys one of the techniques that I have implemented into my training, and it's called reps in reserve. So, what does that mean? It means that when you're working out, and it's not your last set yet, right? So let's say we're doing 5 sets of a certain exercise. What you want to do is, for the first round, you don't want to max out. And by that, I mean, basically, let's say you're doing pull-ups, right? And you know for sure that if you went all out, you can get at least 10 pull-ups. But that last pull-up is sloppy, and you're losing form, you got to kick up a little bit. That's basically maxing out, is that you're taking it to the limit of what you can do. And reps in reserve is very, very easy to learn and very easy to apply. It's basically common sense, not working as hard. So it's like leaving 1, 2, or 3 reps in the tank and not using it yet. But people who train this way, when they realize the results from it, they realize it's more beneficial. I know it doesn't make sense, so that's why I actually made, I actually recorded 2 of my workouts, my dumbbell press workouts, for you guys to see. So what I did, this is very exciting for me to share with you guys. The first workout that I did on Tuesday, I actually maxed out on every single set. I have not done that in so long, so man, it really sucked. But it felt like I was working hard, you know, but I know in the back of my mind that even though I was working very hard, it wasn't very beneficial for me, and I could have gotten a better workout if I had trained smarter. So the first workout, what I did was, like I said, I maxed out on every single set. And the workout was basically dumbbell press, 100-pound dumbbell press, going every 4 minutes. And it's very important to time your workout so that you know that you're not gaining enough, you're not getting more rest time, and you're not getting less rest time. It has to be the same. So for workout number 1 on Tuesday, I used the 100-pound dumbbells going for dumbbell press, and I was going every 4 minutes for 5 rounds, and I was maxing out every single time. So let me show you what happened. Here's the results. As you can see, right, at the end of that workout, I got a total of 49 reps, if you add up all the reps, okay? Now, I'm gonna show you what happens when you actually work out smarter. So, the second workout, what I did, I worked out again on Friday, and this time, on my dumbbell press, I was still going every 4 minutes, okay? Same weight. The only difference now is that I kept it in reserve. So instead of maxing out, right, I only did 11 every set. And the 11 was pretty easy, it wasn't too bad. It's not hard, it's not easy, it's probably in the middle. Sorry, it's in the middle. Sometimes I can't talk. And you're gonna see on set number 5, that's where I always max out. I always max out on the last set to get more out of it and see what I got left in me, right? But this is what happens. You ready for this? First, let me show you what happened. Okay, guys, super cool. Gonna do a voiceover, never done this before. So this is gonna be for set number one. Set number one, I got 11 reps. And set number two, I also got 11 reps, but I forgot to record my first set. So this is actually set number two we're looking at right now, in which I got 11 reps. This is set number three. I also got another 11 reps because remember, I'm keeping my reps in reserve, right? We know that if I fully go out, I can get 16. So 11 is pretty easy. It's very doable. When I'm done with 11, I still feel pretty good. I still feel pretty strong. And this is set number four. I did another 11 reps because I still feel pretty good. I didn't max out yet, so my strength is still there. I'm not super tired, but I know I'm getting a good workout because I'm sweating. Those 100 pounds, they're heavy babies, man. They're like two toddlers in your lap. And then finally, this is the fifth set. So the fifth set is very important. What I always do is I always max out on the last set because now this is the time to shine. This is the time to go all out and give it all you got. So on my last set, I managed to pull out 16 reps. So we add that all up, 11 reps plus 11 plus 11 plus 11 plus 16. That turns out to 60 reps in total. And this is from training smarter, keeping in reserve, and getting much more out of it.
And what's funny is that I actually wasn't working harder in my second workout. I was just working out smarter. And in the end, 60 reps with 100 pound dumbbells is better than 49 reps maxing out all the time, right? But you notice, it's very interesting, is that I was not maxing out on my second workout, but somehow I was able to get more reps. Now, in the future, okay, so let's say that I did 10 workouts, okay? So if I got 49 reps with the max out workout, that means that I will have a total of 490 reps, right, with 100 pound dumbbells. Now, let's say that I trained smarter, I kept in reserve, and I always got 60 every time. 60 times 10 workouts, it comes out to 600 reps. So 10 workouts later, right? There's a wisdom that did 600 reps training smarter versus a wisdom that thought he was training harder by maxing out all the time and he only got 490 reps in total. So that 110 reps, it makes a difference in the long run. And this is what I teach everyone, is that it's important not to max out until the very end, until, you know, it's the last set, it's time to go gung-ho, go Rocky style, and do as many as you can, okay? So that's the whole concept I wanna teach you guys today. A little bit of wisdom I wanna impart onto you. Train smarter, don't train harder. I know that's what we're taught this, train smarter, right? Train smarter. And this is the whole point of me making this video for you guys, to teach you guys this. So it is up to you for you to use, should you wish. I highly advise you use it. It's very good advice from me. I wish that someone had taught me this when I first started. Keep your reps in reserve until the last set. And from there, max out. Do as many as you can. All right, see you guys later.